Hey, you got that easy cheese? That's cool. We can pull that up. Roll up some of that.
Sitting by the open fireplace in my favorite dungarees. Played a few bars of a melody.
Okay. I wanted to talk a little bit today about the worst shooting, mass shooting, in U.S. history. There's a lot of talk right now about Las Vegas, and that Las Vegas is the worst shooting, mass murder, mass shooting in U.S. history. Is it really true? And, you know, I was in Compton the other day talking about Las Vegas, and somebody mentioned Black Wall Street. Well, I don't even know what Black Wall Street was. It shows you, you know, how we're educated in America that somebody who I consider to be pretty much in the know on U.S. history, I'd never heard of Black Wall Street. And when I went to look it up, I saw numerous articles about the Tulsa riots, race riots, and how this was a Tulsa race riot. Well, when you start getting into the eyewitness accounts of what actually happened there, there were planes that were throwing firebombs out of the planes, and there were many, many planes, and they threw these out of the airplane and basically torched the entire town. Now, what was Black Wall Street? Black Wall Street was a community of African Americans that began to prosper. And the minute they started to have their success and they put together a strong and vibrant community, what happens? They are attacked, and that town is completely burned to the ground. Now, the accounts that I read, the numbers of dead start at 300. Some accounts are as high as 600 people that died in the Tulsa race riots. It's not a Tulsa race riot, guys. It is a mass execution. They saw people that were succeeding and starting to prosper. There was some kind of jealousy, and what did they do? They went in and they burned it down. Now, what does this sound like? Doesn't this sound like what we've come to know as putting crack cocaine out in the streets of America to destroy the black family? And, you know, we've been doing these weekly sessions with the former mayor of Compton, Omar Bradley, and he talks about how the black population has remained steady at 40 million people for the last 30, 40 years. And I have to say, if I didn't investigate and see this stuff with my own eyes, I probably wouldn't believe it. And then it leads us to why were Suge and Tupac targeted? Well, Suge Knight had it in his mind that he was going to create his own distribution channel. And that was very intimidating for the powers that be. Back in the day, there were six distribution companies that distributed records. He wanted to be the seventh, and he wanted to call it Lucky Seven. And what happened? Targeted, brought down. What's happening to Suge Knight today? Targeted, still being brought down. He will have lost over 3 years of his life without going to trial by the time he actually does go to trial. And it's a pretty clear open and shut case. I mean, I don't understand why the defense has constantly delayed. But, you know, in Los Angeles, it's not easy to find an attorney who will agree to represent your interests above the interests of the court. Ask any attorney to sign a document saying that they will represent your interests ahead of the interests of the court and see if they sign it. Most likely they will not sign it because They depend upon the courts for their livelihood. And so I'm going to show you some images of Black Wall Street, up to 600 people, maybe even more, that were murdered that day. They didn't keep good statistics because, as you can see, maybe after this whole thing happened, they really wanted to water it down. And instead of calling it what it was, an execution, a massacre, a genocide, they called it the Tulsa Race Riots, like it was a riot. I mean, it just, it's crazy. Gives us some insight into the mainstream media and how they twist and spin things so that it goes down in history as one thing when it's really another. Anyway, more later. Look at these images, they're harrowing.
I'm just sitting back pulling up, man. I'm running out of drink, no. My thoughts is flying. I feel like I need another bottle. I know I don't need it, but this bottle helped me through the world. All the sorrow and pain I see on our women's faces, man, it's like, damn. I done ran out of drink, ran out of money. Now I'm just meditating, getting my mind right, trying to deal with this, but I miss my brandy, man. I need some of that brown, that E and J, that Parmesan. Damn. She was just DJ Dog Mark. Lost my whole bottle.
I'm so all alone. I really miss you, Brandy. I'm so all alone. When are you coming back home? I really miss you, Brandy. Missing you every day. Are you coming home to stay?
Hey, you got that easy cheese? Let's go, we can pull that up. Roll up some of that.
Sitting by the open fireplace in my favorite dungarees. Played a few bars of a melody and it sounded sweet to me. I thought I'd get up and take a look around, but my feet got in the way. Stumbled to the floor, she was right
there. DJ Dark Mark. As I sit back, chill, and just take my time to roll up and bowl up a new Parmesan. Feeling like life so lifeless, the way they got us on this black and this white shit. Why do we go through this up on the regular? And I'm thinking about this, I feel irregular. When I walk down the street and see the police, they wanna see me laying down dead in the streets. I hope my mind make me do these things that don't matter. And that's why I ain't worried about it, I'm getting gladder. While I look at the news and everything looking badder. Another child died and his mama so sadder. Man, I'm getting sick of all this as I reminisce of all the people I really miss. I wish I could meet you, Vita, baby, give you a kiss. It's so sad why they had to take you from this. But this the way we gotta live, take care of the world so we can raise our kids. They got us worried about evolution and pollution. We need a new solution. When will we stop the shooting? Stop the movement. What you gonna do when they stop the grooving? No more music and no more true shit. And this is how you really gotta do this. Present yourself with a plan that is righteous. And make sure that any evil you can fight it. And make sure that it ain't good, you don't like it. They love to see you on some bullshit, excited. They wanna see you fucked up with no license. I'm in the studio flowing and never writing. I know I should put it down on paper. My mind copyrighted, I ain't worry, hater. So understand while I'm sipping on this brandy. Got me gone while I'm rolling up the candy. Switch sweet, tastes good between my lips. Wishing I could make it out when I reminisce. The world's so messed up and devilish. I'm just sitting back pouring up, man. I'm running out of drink.